Hello everyone, in this tutorial we'll see how to create this really cool design that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Okay, so let's open Photoshop. And then I will go to File, New, and let's create a new file using 3000 pixels for the width, and let's see, maybe I will put 4000 for the height and keep 72 in the resolution and I'll press OK. Now I will go to this adjustment icon and I will create a solid color and let's keep it 75% brightness to be this grayish color. Alright, and let's delete this background. Alright, now we'll go and open the image I will be using. So we'll drag it and open it just right here. And let's cut it from the background. So I will go to select and choose subject. Yeah. Alright, so I think this is a decent selection. So I'm not gonna modify it or anything. So I'm just gonna one click on this layer mask. And this will apply the selection in here. And then I'm gonna press B to switch to my move tool. And I will drag it to the other tab and I will close this one and let's not save it. Alright, now I'm gonna right click and choose convert to smart object and then I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command T and I will make it smaller. Actually I want to cut all this in here, so let's make it a little bit bigger to be just in the center of the face, maybe a little bit bigger. So let's make it a little bit bigger, just like right there. All right. Now I want to cut all this in here. So I'm just going to go to the pen tool. And let's cut all this to have like a side portrait in here. All right. So after I finish with the pen tool, I'm just going to press Control or Command Enter to load the selection and I will apply the layer mask and let's invert it. So I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command I and this will invert it like that. Alright, now let's take this and put it in the center. Now I want actually to flip it, so I'm just gonna press Ctrl or Command T again and right click and flip it horizontally because I want the face to be looking that way. Alright. Next, I will go to my text tool or to the type tool and I will make sure that I'm selecting vertical type tool. And with the font that's called Anton, I'm just gonna one click and let's type something, for example, calm. All right, and let's place it as right here. Maybe I will make it a little bit smaller. So I want this C to be following this hair in here. So let's see if we can do that. But also I want it to be close to this ear because I want it to be outside of the text. So let's make it a little bit smaller, all the text just right here. And then I'm gonna actually make it a little bit wider by pressing shift. And I'm just gonna cheat a little bit to making this a little bit wider. And this is not recommended because you're gonna make your text look out of proportion. Sometimes you can get away with it. All right, something like that. Actually, let's make the opacity a little bit down to see where to put this scene here. So you want it to be somewhere in this area in here. I'm just gonna move it a little bit to the left. All right. I think I'm happy with this, so I'm just gonna press on this check mark to commit the change and I will put back the text set to 100%. Alright, so this is a fairly easy effect to make or design to do, but somehow I feel like this with the side portrait it will look much better than the other tutorial that I did. So let's see. So we're gonna follow the same thing. We're gonna actually make a copy of this image that we have in here. So I'm just gonna press Alt or option, and I will take it up. This will allow me to duplicate it while I'm pressing Alt or Option. And then I'm going to create a clipping mask by pressing Alt again and go between the text and image. And as you can see, the arrow will change and I will just one click. And this would clip it. Now you can see that it's clipped because this one is in here. It's obstructing. If I hide it, you can see how it's clipped to the text. Alright, now I will go and select the first image that we had, and I will go to the marquee tool and let's make a rectangle just like that, somewhere around here, and then I'm gonna delete from the layer mask. Make sure that you have white as your foreground color, and this will allow you to delete. Alright, I think it looks okay. And then we can always go back and move the text itself, something like that. So I think this looks okay. Let me just put the text a little bit down, and I will move it a little bit more to this side. All right, I'm happy with this. So now I will open the layer style from the text in here. So I will go to this FX icon and choose blending options. Alright, and I will go to stroke, and I will make sure that the stroke matching the background that we have in here, the color of the background. So I'm just gonna eyedrop it, and for the size I think I will put 15 pixels. I have the position set to outside normal with 100% opacity, and I will press OK. Alright, as you can see, our effects, it starts to get in shape. But as I say before, I want the ear to be excluded from the text that we have in here. So to do that, I will actually make another copy of the image by pressing Alt or Option again, and I will drag it on top. And then I'm gonna make sure that this layer mask is set to black. So I'm gonna press X to invert black as my foreground color. And then I'm gonna press Alt or Option, backspace, and I will fill the layer mask with black color. And then I'm gonna press B to open the brushes, and I will make sure that the opacity is set to 100 and the flow to set to 100 too. And I will make my brush smaller, and I can bring back, using white as my foreground color, can bring back the details from the ear in here. Alright, as you can see, we have now the ear excluded from the text, which give it a very nice detail to the whole thing. Alright, now I want actually to apply some effects. This is optional, you can leave it like this if you want. But for me, I think I want to apply some lights coming from here and a little bit from here. Maybe a little bit of shadow in here. So let's see. And to do that, I want actually to make a selection of the whole thing, the image and the text itself. So to do that, I will go and select or load the selection of the main image by pressing Ctrl or Command. This will allow me to load the selection of the main image, but I don't want the whole selection. I want only this part in here. So to do that, I'm gonna press Ctrl, Shift and Alt all together. And this will create this X icon next to the hand of the mouse. So while I'm pressing all of that, I'm gonna one click to the layer mask. And as you can see, it's excluded everything. All right, now we have the selection of this part of the face. Now I want to add to the selection of the text. I want to add it to the whole selection that we have in here. And to do that, it's fairly easy. I will go to the text, and by pressing Ctrl Shift, I can actually add to the selection. So while I'm pressing Ctrl Shift and I have this selection loaded, I will one click on the text. And as you can see, we have the whole selection of the image that we have in here, or all the portrait. Alright, after that, I'm gonna create a new layer, and I'm gonna fill this selection with whatever color I want. So I just want it to be saved. So I'm gonna press Alt or Option, backspace. And there we go, we have the selection. And by the way, we forgot this part of the ear that we didn't select. And to do that, it's very easy. You remember that we created this and you actually we duplicated this on top. So to do that, to add to the selection of the ear, can you just press Ctrl Shift again and one click on the layer mask, and this will add it to the selection. And now I will go to my new layer, let's call it selection, and then I'm gonna fill it. Maybe let's use another color, maybe red, and I'm gonna press Alt Backspace or Option Backspace and Ctrl D to deselect. And there we go, we have a silhouette of the whole selection. All right, now whenever we want to select this, we can just go and press Ctrl Command and one click, and this will allow us to select it. All right, now I'm gonna create a layer and let's call it shadows and highlight. Now I will go and choose a black color, and I will go to my gradient tool, and I will make sure that the gradient is set to color to transparent in here. So in the basic, make sure that you are selecting the middle one in here, and also make sure that you are selecting the linear gradient. All right, so I want a little bit of shadow or a little bit of contrast coming from here. So while I'm having the selection on, I'm just gonna go to this side and I will one click and drag to make a gradient like that, maybe a little bit like this. And then I will switch to a white color and I will go right here and I will one click and drag again from the top area. All right, and I will do the same in this side too, maybe not that strong, maybe in here a little bit less. All right, something like that. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command D, and as you can see, we have this kind of shadow and highlight. And then I'm gonna switch Blender Mode to something that will look good. For example, soft light, just to add a little bit of character to the whole design. And then I'm gonna drop down the opacity to around 50% or 60%. I mean, this is optional, but for me, I like to have a little bit of pop out of the design. All right, next I will go to adjustments and choose levels, and I will play with the RGB in here a little bit, red and yellow, blue, and then I will go to the RGB and I will add a little bit of contrast to the whole thing, then like that. Maybe drop down the blacks a little bit. And I will drop down the opacity again to like 70%. And let's see before and after. So I'm gonna group these two together and we'll see before and after. Definitely give a lot of character to the whole thing. All right, one last thing. I will open the group and then I will go to adjustments and I will choose solid color. And let's choose like a desaturated yellow, maybe a little bit orangey yellow, something like this one in here. And I will change the blending mode to exclusion. And I will drop down the opacity to like 14 or 15%. And now let's see before and after. Definitely a lot better now. Alright, and that would be our tutorial. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.